Me and my brother take care for the sorting of the fish, treatments, selling, etc. So we feed about between 100 and 150 kilos of feed per day. As you can see, the stream is very small, but it has a good temperature, which is in the range between 7 and 17 degrees Celsius. So we are not far away from the spring of the water. There are many small springs. There is no fish in the stream, so we are sure that we are a disease-free farm. This is the inlet of the water, yes? These pipes with the small holes. We take about 7 liters per second of water.
By gravity?
By gravity goes in the first building. From the first building go by the gravity in the second building, where is the pumps and filters and everything. Other farmers in Slovenia feed maybe 8 months per year, because the summer is too hot and the winter is too cold, but we feed every day. First building was built 7 years ago. We built it by ourselves, and second building we built with EU money, supported by EU project. The idea was to produce in the first building the fingerlings on the fresh water, and then use this fresh water for on growing. Our first knowledge or idea was to produce fish up to 30 grams on the fresh water and then put in the recirculation. But during the practice we realized that we can put fish of 3 grams in the recirculation. So this building you will see has the 3 tanks. The first tank is running on the fresh water and other 2 are connected to recirculating water. So only 1 tank is now running by fresh water and everything else is run by the recirculation.
So you start the cycle with 3 gram juveniles?
No, we buy the fish with just lose the yolk sock, and we feed them in the small plastic tanks up to the 3 grams, and then we move to the recirculation system.
Okay, so you don't have broodstock?
No, we don't have broodstock. We buy the fries, mm-hmm. But we don't have good enough water for first stage of losing soil, because something is muddy water and the fluctuation in temperature. So my colleague has the hatchery and they have traced, they put 1 tray for me, and when the fish start to eat, I take them here.
It's a hatchery in Slovenia too?
Yeah, many. We have many hatcheries in Slovenia.
You talk about brown trout, isn't it?
Brown trout or rainbow, the same. We produce both, but our major species is the brown trout.
What is the density? You mentioned the density you have of fish.
Our main density is maximum 60 kilos per cubic of water.
Mm-hmm. You have to get your own generator of oxygen?
Yes.
Because there is no oxygen available in Slovenia like you...
It is, but it's 3 times more expensive. Okay. It's small market and everything is expensive. Delivery is expensive. We don't have big factories which take a lot of liquid oxygen, so the price is 3 times higher than abroad. That's why we decided to produce oxygen.
So you have 1 generator, also electric generator for the oxygen generator?
Yes, and backup in the oxygen bottles. If something happened, we can stay 2 days without an oxygen generator, and then we are forced to buy oxygen. It's important to have backup system. If we lose the electricity, then the electricity generator will start to work. If it fails, we have the oxygen in the bottles, which goes by the pressure out. So it gives us some time for reaction. You know that recirculation, the major thing, it works perfect until stops. When it stops, you can go home. So this is the... But it's not so fragile and sensitive system as we thought before. And because we don't have the natural resources in the future, I think that only possible way to increase production will be in the recirculation system. We don't see other possibility in Slovenia. Why it's must you have a deep hole? Because of the pressure. You have 1.6 bar on 16 meter, and water mixed with oxygen travel 60 meter up, down 60 meter up, and you can dissolve up to 300% of oxygen in the water. So you don't lose the oxygen, because the distance plus pressure will dissolve almost all the oxygen. It works similar like oxycone, if you know how it looks, oxycone.
Yeah.
It's conical shape, and you also mix the water and the oxygen on the top. The oxygen go down, and then you have the valve when you increase the pressure on 3 bars. But you always torture the pump, so you need a lot of energy for the pump. For instance, we use now 500 watt pumps, and with oxycone we use 2.5 3 kilowatt pump. So we reduce the energy consumption with this U-tube system. It's very simple, and we also dissolve ozone in the same U-tube. Ozone generator produces maximum 10% of the purity of the ozone. So if you want to have 100 grams of ozone, you must put 1 kilo of oxygen in the system. And most of the system using oxygen in the CO2 stripper, so it goes through the like a mesh, and with the vacuum they take out the ozone, not to stay in the air, but at the same time you take out the oxygen, so you're losing 90% of the oxygen. So we have the CO2 strippers, but we decide to use it in the U-tube because we want that our ozone stay as the oxygen in the water. So this farm use now 14 kilowatts of electricity per hour, which is quite low for the recirculation system of this capacity. For disinfection, we use peroxide with paracetic acid or something. Using ozone for disinfection, it's maybe better idea UV lamp, more efficient, because it's you need 5 minutes retention time. You need very big storage tank and high concentrations of ozone to destroy some 100% bacteria or something.
It should be dangerous also for the fish.
Very dangerous.
If you don't control it, I know a lot of farms who kill a lot of fish
with ozone.